I gave some lectures at a Kyushu Institute of Technology in Japan, and they appointed me officially to be an extraordinary professor. And I thought, that is a great name. Extraordinary professor. I asked them, what does it mean? And they said, well, you know how there's associate professor and you can become a professor? So an extraordinary professor, you can aspire to be an ordinary professor. So I'm aspiring to be ordinary.
So robotics has been around in academia for a long time, but we're trying to bring it out to the real world.
The world was lacking that kind of central robotics hub.
Willow was a place where its reason for existing was to advance the field of robotics.
What was Willow Garage?
I think of Willow Garage as one person. Scott.
So Scott Hassan had this vision that he wanted to fund work and give back to the community.
It wasn't to make money. It wasn't to sell things.
Scott had a building that was meant for like 150 people. And he, like, the first day of work, he's like, welcome to work. And it was four people in a building meant for 150 people.
But what he said he wanted to do was, you know, fill this building with interesting people doing interesting stuff around autonomous technology.
And you would see robots running everywhere. It was like a playground. It looked like people were having too much fun to be doing serious work.
He said, I've got this building, I've got funds for a bunch of people. Do you want to join? And I said, no. And he said, what do you mean, no? I said, well, we haven't even talked about what we're going to do, so how do I know if I can help? So he went away and thought about it and came back a couple of weeks later and said, self-driving cars are pretty cool and stuff like that.
In the early days, Willow Garage was in a mode of attracting people who they thought would contribute somehow. And I don't think I would be wrong in saying that there wasn't always a clear plan for what everybody was going to do.
When I started there, I worked on an autonomous car. And then we kind of transitioned out of the autonomous car, and then we worked on an autonomous boat. And then we transitioned out of an autonomous boat, and then we worked on a personal robot. And then once the personal robot was pretty much working, then we worked on like apps, so beer out of a fridge, pool table.
We tended to bring people in, and then they found a place, and then, you know, if it was a good match, they'd figure out how to contribute.
I worked on everything that you could imagine in terms of the field of robotics.
Yeah, sort of after, when people started learning more about ROS and about the PR2 and seeing all of this really amazing progress and research that was coming out of Willow Garage, it became clear that Willow was kind of at the forefront of so much of robotics.
I think the open source culture was a really important part of what Willow Garage was. It made us want to share with others. We had a non-NDA disclosure at the front desk.
There was a lot of skepticism at the beginning, right? Like, oh, this is a commercial entity. Do I want to give my stuff away? Open source was the only way to get over that. Traditional investors involved, they'd be saying, well, where's your IP? How are you protecting this? And Scott just didn't worry about that. He said, we're going to do something great and good things will happen.
He was looking to make a contribution and felt like the right thing to do would be to support the development of the open source building blocks in that field that would be analogous to the ones that had been provided to him in the early days of the internet.
And he wanted to make the ecosystem, put it in place for that industry, which was a long-term vision, right? And most people don't have the luxury of having that vision, but he did, and he put his money where his mouth was.
Which actually echoes back to 10 years earlier at Stanford, when the sort of attitude of Scott and Larry Page and the other people in that group was, we're going to build something for people to use, and then we'll figure out how to make money off of it, right? That's a very internet startup kind of attitude. And then we just had this amazing intern program that, yeah, we should talk about. Yeah, cool.